Hello, everybody. Welcome to night 3 of Hellblade: Suena Sacrifice. So, had a mishap with recording last night. I thought my stream wasn't working, so I was like, "Well, screw it. I'm gonna stop streaming." And then, because of a hard drive issue, none of the video actually got saved to my hard drive. However, my stream was working, so some of the stream got saved. So it sucks. So there's a lot missing. There's a lot missing from last night's stream, like the whole entire second half of that trickster demon or whatever he is, because I beat him. Like, I've killed him. Like, this is where I fought him, was right here, and he's dead. It was a really cool and really fun fight, and I'm really disappointed that it didn't get recorded. So, my Twitch dashboard is doing the same thing it was doing last night, but I know it's recording, and that's how I saved some of the stream from last night, was because Twitch saved it for me, because they're awesome. I'm just gonna do the thing. That way I have a backup. These taste terrible. That's not okay. These Oreos taste bad. Oh. No, I don't know. This was the door. That was a door that I couldn't get in. So, now that I have the other mark, I can open that doorway.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And then she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. In the trees. The mountains. Caves.
I'm gonna start seeing faces and shit and stuff. Is that what I'm gonna start seeing? Like, I basically already hear voices in my head. I don't necessarily need to start seeing things either, guys. That'd be really cool if that could not happen. I'm gonna try to be more talkative. I know the very first night, my kids were sleeping right up the hallway here. This way. Bloop, bloop. That way. So I was trying to be quieter, but they're in my bedroom, which is further away tonight, and the door's closed and stuff.
I wonder, can you see the faces too?
Yeah, I probably can.
They're there, if you look for them.
I really want to, can I see shit? Shit. I have been seeing those faces already. The one in the waterfall. Yeah, you guys remember that shit.
Senua, you have the sight. Just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness.
Oh man, that's crazy.
But when it did come, first came for her mother.
Come
on. Senua still sees her face from time to time. hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over.
Yeah, I saw her that in like the...
She misses her so much.
In the waterfall. Oh, man. I'm ADD as hell, so I got lost in my train of thought, but I'll try to be more talkative these times around. But this game is just so enthralling that it's hard to just not be like, ugh. Show up and stop me trying to open this door. Belrevin, that was the crazy dude. He was fearsome too, man.
Why is she waiting? She open has the gate. To open the
no,
gate.
Don't. No, it's dangerous. It's dangerous. Don't open the gate. Don't.
She's done it.
Oh man.
It's so dark. It's dark. The dark. Oh, the dead may cross.
I got it all together.
No one here but me.
But you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved. Carry his vessel to bring him back home.
Oh. This is a flashback of where she has the head.
You did this! No!
They can break you.
I had to make sure it was good for my
compared. Promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness, you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart.
Oh. That's why she has the head. That's why she has his head. That's his head.
The darkness touched you. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender, abandon, to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Dude. Oh, wow. Well, it's all filled with water now. Jeez, okay.
It's your calling.
Scary voice. I think I get it.
It's hurt, this blood. Finish
this. I have no idea what they're saying, but I like the music a lot. Man, let's hope that badass Viking song is gonna keep going. And it's dark.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
Oh, Jesus. Look at that motherfucker. He's a new one. Whoa. Yeah, another shield. Shield, dude. The shields. What was that? Was that a good thing or a bad thing? I think you flipped me over a shield.
Nearly over. Finish it.
Okay. New enemy, big axe dude. More of the same stuff, more of the same dudes. I just want to look around, like, at this game. Like, it's so awesome. It's awesome. This is the way to go, right? Yeah, okay. More runes. S-N-X.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself to its secrets, and you will find yours.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hel, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hel to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
The giantess. Alright, so that sounds cool. Alright, we're gonna find these rooms because we need to get through that door. Oh yeah, that's right, we're gonna have like glowing, they're gonna glow red or whatever, right? We're gonna see them in my face. So this is locked, right? Yeah, I can get through there. And there's so many sounds going on. The audio engineering in this is absolutely phenomenal. There's like floating pieces here. Like, what is that about? See if there's any clues down here. Okay, like weird noise. Voice is telling me to focus. I don't know. Whoa. Okay. It's another new gameplay mechanic. I'll so really fucking cool. It looked like there was something weird there. Okay. The S rune. There it is. All right. Very cool. Very cool, very cool, very good. I have a weird feeling that I might be towards the end of the game, which is, like, gonna make me really sad. I hope it's not this short.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold all will stumble. Her bed is called sickbed. And her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh, and her face menacing and grim.
That sounds terrible. So that just leads me back out to here. Getting that, like, I can almost describe it like a glitch. Is there a... Oh, it's a letter up here. I need to go this way. Ah, here we go. Ah, there it is. This one I got quick. You actually see down there a little bit. Open sesame. am I going to get blown off this bridge? I really hope I'm not going to get blown off this bridge. I do not want to be blown off the bridge.
The gate is opening.
Who is it?
It's coming.
That song again.
Yes, the source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
I'm sorry. I can't watch this.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior. You're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it.
She's scared. She's scared. She's scared.
Get up. Get up. Get up and fight.
Jesus. Man, okay. Some deep shit.
Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye.
Mm-hmm.
But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares?
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be there, to be honest.
Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
A shadow.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself. Because there's no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering.
Jesus.
Broken and lost. Just do like it. Your sword.
Come on.
Man, my sword's broken. No.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song.
Come to me.
Please.
The light. Go towards the light. It's him. There he is. It can't be him. It's just a trick. It's in your mind.
No, he's here.
It's in your mind.
It's real. It's happening.
Go towards it.
Jesus. She is. Of course, Senna was even more broken than she was when I began this game. Generally, going towards the light is not what you want to do. Swim. God, this game's magnificent. I still haven't made it across the damn bridge. I don't have my sword. How am I supposed to get through the rest of this game?
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zimbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
There's like a structure over there. I thought I saw a cave over this way. Is there a cave over here? I'm gonna double check, make sure there's not a cave over here. Might be a cool cave. It was just wall. Rock wall.
There he was, the lone figure of a boy, a swordplay under the shade of a tree. She remembers the first time she saw him.
So
to her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. For the first time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
That's some deep shit, man.
His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Oh, what a jerk. I saw this little thing first. I can't go to it. I think... Is there two paths to go? Two paths, because there's some stairs over here. I'm gonna check the stairs. Kinda looks like a face right there. Oh, that's supposed to be a face, but that looks like a face too.
Death for Sigmund and his brother seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead.
Chain them up?
He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left.
Jesus.
The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
What happened? What is this? I can't even access that yet, huh? Okay. Some different ways to go, which is kind of cool. There's that. Yeah, that was just up there. For the detour, folks. Oh. want to make sure I find that, that rune so I know the story. I just saw it for a second. Was this like a different way I could have gone? What's this?
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free.
Whoa.
After his escape,
Sigmund's badass.
Like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister, wants revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan. One that is cold of heart. Pure blood.
At the end of it? Okay. I wish those just kept, like, kept going no matter how far you got away from it, because I want to hear, like, the backstory of all of those, because it's so good. You have to stand there and listen to it, which I don't want to do. I just want this girl to, like, succeed and be happy, like, with what's happening. Like, that's all I want. I know this can't end well, though.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I'm not. I don't leave home much.
Oh. Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are.
you killed him.
But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her.
Man, Northmen sucks.
Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, and don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here.
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up!
You want to believe it.
Is
he
not
real?
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Delia?
Nothing lives here.
You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
If that's nothing, no, it's not activated yet. Another story. There's another one of those. I think that's where I was before I. So that's where I started crossing the bridge, I think? Well, I don't know.
Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother.
Ugh.
She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli.
Sinfjotli.
After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy, and finds him strong and fearless, and so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. But luck is not on their side. They're captured, and Siggeir has them buried alive.
Ugh. Man, that sucks. It's like his... and his sister. That's weird.
As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive,
I wonder if those light up.
Sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave mound and set fire to Siggeir's hall. The king burns to death.
Neat.
Sigmund calls to his sister to come out so that she may live and be honored. She does come out, but only to tell him the truth. That she had slept with him, her brother, to beget a strong avenger. I am not fit to live, she says, and walks back into the fire.
Whoa.
Strike vengeance from your heart, Senua, as there is always a heavy price to pay.
Yeah. Revenge is never good. Free now. that a new sword?
Take it.
A sword.
Take it.
Important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gramr by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards.
Oh,
go to
shit.
The shards.
Go to the shards. What's the shard? Find it.
God, I want to keep playing this so bad, but this would be such a perfect place to cut. There's gonna be trials. Almost an hour, so I'm gonna cut here, I think. So I think it was the perfect place to like cut, like, oh man, cool cliffhanger, blah. Even though I really, really want to keep playing. Man, this game was like really good, and I was thinking I was getting close to the end of it, but like these trials and stuff might be a lot longer than I was thinking.
I don't know.
It's really freaking awesome. Hopefully you guys are enjoying this series. I just am posting the very first stream on my YouTube channel tonight. This is my third night streaming this. So if you guys really are really liking it, please let me know in the comments below and stuff, because I will go back and redo the fight with the trials and stuff with Bell Revan, I think his name is Bell Revan. He's like this weird, like, crow demon god shit thing. Like, he has all these illusions. It was, like, really good. It was really awesome. I'm really disappointed that I didn't get the footage on it. So if you guys want that, please let me know in the comments below. I will go back and do it. I'm sorry, I'm in the middle of my camera. It's dark. Everywhere. Until next time, guys, please be kind to each other, and I'll see you guys in the next video.